Hello, I am Fela, the discussion leader of the second group. Our group will discuss about South Korean culture and tradition. Now, I am going to mention the three questions that I've made with the answer for each question. So, let's get started. First, where is Korea located? Korea is a small peninsula located between China and Japan. Why do Koreans bow when meeting a person? They bow as a sign of gratitude and respect to the person they are meeting. Nobody's going home tonight. Third, if you are an adult, will you live with your parents and taking care of them as Koreans do? Yes, I will. I think it's obligationally become my duty to take care of them after they are taking care of me since I was a baby. Yet, if I am getting married later, I think it's going to be a little different. Because most of people in our country will live with their own new little family after getting married. According to them, after getting married, they are going to through a new stage in their life. So, they will live independently in their own new house instead of living with their parents anymore. Well, that's all from me. Another information will be delivered by my friends.
Hello guys, my name is Fathan, and as a summarizer, I will give you some information about South Korean culture and traditions. The capital city of South Korea is Seoul. The official name of South Korea is the Republic of Korea in English and Daehanminguk in Korean writing. Korean culture is very interesting and full of wonderful traditions. As one of the oldest continents cultures in the world, Koreans have passed down their traditional narrative in a variety of ways. Hangul is the name of the Korean alphabet. There are 5 major dialects in South Korea and 1 in North Korea. Despite differences in the dialects, speakers from different areas can understand each other. Korea is greatly influenced by Chinese and Japanese culture. This influence can be seen by Confucianism, which established many traditions that can be seen in modern Korea today. Koreans also believe in sincerity and loyalty and follow certain codes of conduct while meeting, eating, praying, and even celebrating. Family is the most important part of Korean society. They also believe in a hierarchical structure and children help their parents and must obey them and show respect to the elders. They believe in duty, loyalty, honor, and sincerity. That's why children live with their parents after they become adults as they believe it is their duty to take care of their parents. Confucianism, Buddhism, and Christianity are the main religions. Buddhism is the religion in Korea with the most followers and its teaching have a great impact on Koreans' lifestyle, culture, and art. The division of Korea has also caused a divergence in religious life in the two countries due to the different political structure. South Korea has been characterized by a rise of Christianity and Buddhism, while North Korea is considered a secular state. Korean festivals are full of life, colors, and joy, and they are celebrated throughout the year. Most celebrations and festivals are related to harvest and family. Korean society depends on farming, so many of their celebrations focus on events to pray for a good harvest. Korean cuisine is largely based on rice, noodles, vegetables, and meats. The Korean culture is based on politeness and respect, and this is clearly evident in Korean table manners. Here are some Korean manners for sharing meals with others.
The first, older people should sit down first at the table. The second, a guest says, 잘 먹겠습니다, which means, I will enjoy the meal, as a sign of respect to the host. The third, eat at the same place of other people sitting at the table. And the last is, chew your food with your mouth closed and do not make noises while chewing. Well, that's all for me. Another information will be delivered by my friends. Thank you!
Hi, I'm Fadhila as the connector of the second group. So, let's get started. South Korea has the same fate as Indonesia, which was colonized by Japan. However, Indonesia was colonized for 3.5 years, while South Korea was for 35 years. The text also reminds me of Korean drama that I have watched. There are scenes where they respect the elders and the family. Koreans also bow when meeting each other as a sign of respect. It is different from Indonesia because we used to shake hands instead of bow. Before I read this text, I thought that the majority of South Koreans didn't have any religion or well known as an atheist. In fact, the majority of South Koreans are Buddhist and Christian. Koreans' dependence on the agriculture sector reminds me with condition of Indonesia, which is mostly used for the agricultural sector. Korean also has an event to pray for a good harvest, and Indonesia has to. In Indonesia, it's called petik padi. Nowadays, we don't have to go to South Korea when we want to eat Korean food such as bibimbap or kimchi. We can find it easily in Indonesia. It is because of acculturation and globalization. In our group's opinion, Korean culture is very interesting in many ways, such as table manners, bow as a sign of respect, and the meals. The moral values that we can take from Korean culture are respect to older people, do anything with sincerity and loyalty. Well, that's from me. Another information will be delivered by my friend.
My name is Nur Tri Intan Ayu. I'm investigator of Group 2. Korea is a region in East Java divided between two distinct sovereign states, North Korea and South Korea since 1948. Korea consists of the Korean Peninsula, Jeju Island, and several minor islands near the peninsula.
The custom of bowing is habitual and deeply ingrained in Koreans, but it can be a source of anxiety and worry for foreigners. When do I bow? How do I bow? Or there are different kinds of bows for different situations? Well, I often my Korean friends if I don't bow. Bowing is not the only custom that puzzles foreigners in Korea. Sometimes Koreans bow while shaking hands, and it's polite to return the gesture. Respect for age and seniority is still a huge part of Korean culture and influences how one bows to others.
South Korea, which offers some of the world's best skincare products, has also been reported to have the highest per capita rate of cosmetic surgery in the world, with 1 in 3 women in the country aged between 19 and 29 reported to have gone under the knife, according to a 2015 survey by Gallup Korea. The most popular procedures were reported to be eyelid surgeries. The streets of Gangnam, the capital's upmarket financial district located south of the Han River, which bisects the city, house several cosmetic clinics, while the city's major stations are filled with giant advertisements for cosmetic surgery showing women with the perfect face. For most locals, English is sorely lacking. This means good job prospects for English teachers, but finding a local to communicate in good English is tall order. Don't be surprised to be mistaken for an English teacher, and try to handle their practice question gracefully. This is actually changing. Now, it is not difficult to find an English speaker. If you just ask around in Seoul in any crowded area or in the subway, you should find at least a few English speakers.
Okay, thank you for watching. I hope you guys like the video, and then see you next time.